Welcome to the channel, everyone. BLN437, and before we get on with this video, I just wanted to let you guys know how the comment section should work down below. Now, I do want people to express their opinions, yes, and I do want people to comment and let me know what they think about everything that's going on, everything that's going on in their head about the topic of the video or anything that I do. But I want it to be done in a respectable way. I want to be able to build a community here that's nice, that's easy to, you know, be around, and you don't have to feel like you're being pressured into attacking somebody else because you got attacked or because you think you're getting attacked. I want people to be able to respect each other. Understand that this is just a game at the end of the day. It's going to be there for many, many years. Our teams are still going to be there for many, many years. So at the end of the day, let's just enjoy this season while we can and enjoy what little bit is left. But I also, like I said, I know I can't have everybody be a good seed. I know there's going to be one bad seed here or there, and I'm not talking about anybody in the comment section last night. I'm just talking about in general, leading going forward as well. It's going to happen, unfortunately. This is the internet. That's how it works. But if we can try to keep it as clean as we can and be respectable to one another, that's all that I care about, and that's all that I want. But anyways, guys, let's get over with that topic. I think that it's obvious what we need to do. But let's talk about the National League Championship Series, Game 4 between the Chicago Cubs and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Now, the Dodgers go into this game. They were up 3-0. You had Alex Wood versus Jake Arrieta on the mound, and Jake needed to have a masterful performance here today, and he did. He did his job. He went 6 2/3 innings, and he was able to get it to the bullpen, and he was able to do what he needed to do. And Wade Davis got the 2-out save, which was important. I kept saying that they need to go to Wade Davis. They need to get the ball to Wade Davis. You can't trust anybody else in that pen. Probably Rendon, probably Strope. But you have to get Davis in the pen. And I also challenged this Cubs team. I said I wanted them to win this game just to at least make the series interesting. Even though this isn't necessarily interesting because they're still up 3-1, at least give us something to talk about here. And they finally showed up. And the person that finally showed up was one of the guys that I criticized in yesterday's video, Javier Baez. Javier Baez had 2 home runs in this game, and that was pretty much the entire Cubs offense. The 2 home runs with Contreras' home run, which, I mean, it's still not Bryant and Rizzo doing any damage, which is what you really want as well. But at least Baez is starting. At least I hope he's starting to come back to that Baez form that we saw last year. If not, and this was just a one-shot thing, then that's pretty depressing. That'll be pretty depressing because he hasn't had a great regular season. Didn't really have a great postseason this year, so we'll see. If you're the Dodgers, you're happy though. You're still up 3-1. You're not really too worried. You were able to get to Davis today, even if you didn't get this win. He had to go 2 innings. He had to throw a lot of pitches just to win this game for the Cubs. So the Cubs bullpen is weak. It still has a lot to. They still have a lot of work if they want to get back into this game. They still have this series. They have a lot of work to do. I mean, like I said, you look at Jake's line. What really killed Jake was the walks. He had 5 walks with 9 strikeouts, but still, 5 walks with 9 strikeouts, that's just too many pitches. You're getting into too many counts where you're either trying to get a strikeout or you're walking a batter. That's not what you need. He did give up 1 run, which was not the Taylor home run, Jesus. Why did I say Taylor? The Bellinger home run, which made it a 1-2 game. But then after that, he was, like I said, he was still decent enough, even though he walked a couple of guys. Still decent enough, and he did his job. And then Davis came in for Chicago, and Turner hit a home run that made it 2-3. So, yeah, you know, Wade Davis didn't look the best, but Wade Davis still got the job done. Turner continues his great postseason hitting. Same thing with Bellinger. I said he needed to show up. He's kind of showed up a little bit in this series. That's huge. That's what you want if you're the Dodgers. And like I said, at the end of the day, you didn't use Jensen. You know, you were able to get Wade Davis to go 2 innings, so he's not available for tomorrow's game, which is what the risk that Joe Maddon had to take at this point, because you weren't going to be able to lose this series not having your best pitcher come in for a 3-out save. It just wasn't going to happen. I mean, you look at the lineup, like I said, Schwarber 0-4 still. Bryant went 0-4. Rizzo went 0-3. That's still not good enough. And what really helped, at least to me, what really helped the Dodgers, I mean, the Cubs win this game was the Dodgers had their key guys that didn't show up really today. Other than the home run, Bellinger was 1-5. Chris Taylor was 0-3. Puig was 1-3, but he didn't really do much. Granderson and Ethier were 0-4 combined. So overall, they were able to control the offense, which was important because you need to be able to control the Dodgers' offense, because if they get a lead, going into the sixth or seventh inning, you got to deal with that tough bullpen, and then you got to deal with Jansen coming in the eighth or potentially in the ninth if you still got a, you know, a tight lead in the ninth inning. So I don't want to say that this series is over, because you don't ever want to say any series is over, but I mean, the Cubs have to go maybe. I mean, the Cubs are going to have to try to do the best. I mean, I don't think they can do it. I don't think it's going to happen. But they're going to try. You got Kershaw tomorrow. I don't know who's pitching for the Cubs tomorrow. I think it might be Lester from what I was seeing. I have to make sure that I check that out later on tonight, so that way I can have the recap for you guys ready tomorrow. But I believe it's Lester that's going to be on the mound tomorrow. And if you're a Dodger fan, listen, you're still excited. You're still in this, you know, you're still ahead in this series 3-1. You were able, like I said, you were able to get to Davis. That was important. Even though guys like Bellinger, Turner, and Taylor didn't hit, I expect those guys to hit. I mean, there's really nothing much to talk about in this game as well, because if you look at it, yeah, the Dodgers had some chances to score some runs with the walks that Jake Arrieta had kind of set for himself. But at the end of the day, their offense was dead, pretty much. You know, their offense was pretty much dead. You had, other than the Bellinger and Turner home run, they couldn't do anything. Baez pretty much took over the game with two home runs. And that was it. I mean, that was the moral of the story for this game. After Hugh Darvish was perfect, and well, not really perfect, but he was decent enough to get them to win last night, Alex Wood just couldn't close it down for them tonight. So that's just what it is. Like I said, I still expect the Dodgers to win this series. Some people may believe that the Dodgers are slowly starting to slip away. I don't think that that's the case. I just think that they ran into a good pitcher that had his stuff tonight, and that's what happened. And it happens to the best of us. It happens to every team. And hey, we get one more baseball game tomorrow, which I'm fine with that, because if the Dodgers had won, we weren't going to get any baseball games until Friday, between the Yankees and the Astros, which is going to be a great series as well and a great game. But overall, I mean, this is just going to be a quick review here. Like I said, Dodgers didn't really do much offensively. They got their walks, their five walks from Jake. There wasn't really any key moment to me in the game. They looked so off against Jake that it didn't really matter that he was walking guys, one. And two, the only key takeaways that you can take from the Dodgers offense is that Turner continues to hit, and Bellinger maybe is starting to get out of that little slump that he's gotten himself into in the postseason. But to me, the key moments that you can take away from this, I guess, is that the Dodgers really haven't missed Seager's bat. And maybe that'll change once they get into the World Series, whether they face the Yankees or the Astros. I think that's still going to be a huge miss, that Yankee bullpen can absolutely just cool that lineup down. And the Astros have Keuchel and Verlander, who can do damage. So the Dodgers are definitely going to need that bat at some point. Is it really hurting them now? No, once again, like I said. So those are the other key takeaways that you can take from this game. And then as for the Cubs, I mean, you just have to hope that Bryan and Rizzo get back to form. If they don't, then obviously you guys already know that this game could be over tomorrow. But I'm glad that once again we get to get some baseball tomorrow. We get to have some postseason baseball tomorrow. And then we get to have the Yankees and the Astros for game freaking six on Friday. And that's going to be a great series as well. So I can't wait to see both of these games. They're going to be great. They're going to be wonderful. I'm hoping for a Yankee-Dodger War Series just for the pure fact that I think that that would be a nice little thing to have. We haven't seen the Yankees and the Dodgers play since 1981. It's an old classic rivalry that a lot of people don't know about. You know, they've been playing each other in the War Series since the 40s. And I just think that that's cool. I think that if you get a chance to have two big market teams play each other and just kind of see LA and New York all the time, or not all the time, but at least see them in the War Series this one year, then that's great. You know, if not, then we'll be seeing the Astros and the Dodgers, or the Astros and the Cubs, if the Cubs can come back, because I'm not going to say that they're out of it, even though more likely they are. And I think that's a thing that a lot of baseball fans talk about. They want to see different, you know, teams play. I understand that the Yankees aren't everybody's cup of tea. Same thing with the Dodgers, but I mean, the Dodgers haven't been to a World Series in I believe since the Gibson game. Where he hit the home run and stuff like that, which was at 87. So it's been a long time. It's been 30 years. And as for the Yankees, it's been since 2009. But I would like to see that. I would definitely like to see the Dodgers just come back and be in a World Series. It's been a long time since people have seen the Dodgers in a World Series. I don't understand why people don't like it, or why people sit here and say, oh, well, it's the Dodgers, it's the big market team, we want to see other teams. the Dodgers haven't been in the World Series in such a long time, guys. So what are you guys talking about that you guys don't want to see the Dodgers in the World Series? I mean, that's just my personal opinion, but hey, that is what it is. But I'm going to end this video right here, guys. I'm going to be watching Game 5 tomorrow, so I'm excited for that, and then I'm excited for the Game 6 on Friday. If you guys like this video, make sure to leave a like down below. Comment as well. Let me know what you guys think about this game. Let me know what you guys think about this series. And share this video with all of your friends. And if you are new, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next freaking video.